I think it was brilliant lecture. I exactly was asking yesterday Moish about striatal cysts because I have few cases. And at the beginning when I started, I was thinking that it's choroplexus cysts. But actually I understood that they are different. And the prognosis was bad, but it was bad absolutely different way for every of the fetuses. And in all the cases, striatal cysts were associated with additional problems. So we'll talk about early detection of spina bifida, because I totally agree with Moishe that it's detectable in first trimester and it's okay, first and beginning of second trimester. So this is question about, so I have many, not many, but I have few cases that ladies that have spina bifida or other neural tube defects, they were taken folic acid and they came back for additional scan. So this is the same lady that she has two children, one of them have spina bifida. Which one has spina bifida? This one or this one? How you can tell? Why we don't know? Why we're trying to detect spina bifida by looking intracranial translucency second, first trimester, but we are not trying to do the, to see, I'm not hearing this. What's the problem? The problem is the shadowing of the bones, yeah? So actually this part which is supposed to be checked and visible is inside of the shadow. Additional problem is that both babies have spina bifida. So lady was taken folic acid, came back and it was spina bifida. So, and both babies, they have spina bifida, it's the same type of spina bifida, but one was low sacral with coverage and second was open. And I just have no time, so that's why I'm running through this lecture fast, and both babies have spina bifida. The question why we use this cross-section in second trimester are not sagittal for detection of spina bifida. And the answer is that it's very easy to do this cross-section and to check for banana sign, and this is two babies for the same mom that both has banana signs and both have spina bifida. And banana sign is invented by a person that really genius, and Moshe already mentioned who is the person, but I want to show you the additional sign that was invented by the same person. And this is Lehmann sign, and also this is both babies, they have Lehmann sign. And this is the publication of this professor, so Kypros Nikolaidis in 1986 found fantastical important thing, that it's very difficult, especially at that time, was to check spine. But to detect spina bifida, you don't need to check spine. You just need to check brain. And if you will have a look on the brain, you will see that the shape of the head is abnormal and brain has banana sign. And they found that practically all the babies with spina bifida, and it was publication in Lancet, have brain symptoms. Now we know that about 5% of babies with spina bifida, they have no cranial signs of, at least they are not prominent cranial signs, but it was the greatest invention of Kypros Nikolaidis, this publication. I think is the best. So why we're scanning spina bifida? Because contrary to other diagnoses, if you have diagnosis of spina bifida, at least two-thirds of the patient will terminate the pregnancy. In some places of the world, and I'm talking about Holland, they even were doing killing of the babies after birth with diagnosis of spina bifida, but doing this termination after birth with support of Association of Pediatrics with support of lawyers, and it's kind of legal termination after birth. Already children that were delivered. So the situation with spina bifida is really very, very serious. So there is new development that many people are skeptical, but there is new development that there is possibility of improvement outcome by doing in utero closure of spina bifida. And my hospital will be the first hospital in United and only hospital in United Kingdom that we will start to do in utero surgery for spina bifida. And this is the team that team is coming from Belgium, with the head of the team is Professor Jan de Prest, well-known fetal surgeon, and they will help us in beginning of this service in the United Kingdom. So, but it's maybe much better to detect spina bifida at early stages, and after to give the lady option or to terminate the pregnancy, or to continue the pregnancy and have surgery, or to continue the pregnancy and have without surgery and deliver the baby with spina bifida. So I think that's important thing in all this is early detection of spina bifida. Now, this is my hypothesis, and it's quite similar to what Moshe tried not showed with the syringe, with the pressure of the syringe. I think that the most important thing in the brain of the fetus at this stage of pregnancy is intracranial pressure. Intracranial pressure, it's some structural element of the fetus brain at this stage. And brain itself is just jelly, and it's supported, and the shape of the head itself is supported by intracranial pressure. Intracranial pressure by itself is function of arterial pressure, so the heart, if the heart is not pumping, so the brain, the head will collapse, and this is recent miscarriage. So the baby was alive 2 days ago, and now is dead. I don't know why it's dead, but I can see that the head is collapsed. So there is no fluid in the head, it's dried up head. And why it happens? It happens because of drop of the pressure intracranial. And I think this part of the difficulties that we have with the confirmation of the diagnosis of first trimester anomalies of CSF of the brain by our pathologists, because they are not able to confirm our findings even by using very, very good technique. So, and this is what I want, the most important thing that I want to tell you. Again, intracranial pressure is structure element of first trimester brain. So this is just explanation of this. So the head, yeah, the shape of the head is okay, but actually the head is not formed. It's not built from the bones. It built from the bones with some membranous part of the head. So, and the support of this structure is like air supported structures. This is image from Wikipedia. So there is some pump that pushing the air inside of this building. So the building exists just because of pressure of the air. At the moment where if the pump stops pumping, or if there is big hole in this wall, so the building will collapse. So, and this is, I think, is good example why if the baby has no heartbeat, so there is collapse of the structures of the brain. So lemon sign, actually it is other representation of this phenomenon, but this is a late presentation. When the same Kypros Nikolaidis tried to find if lemon sign present at the babies with spina bifida at early stage of pregnancy, he found that just in 3 cases from from 29, so it was Lehmann sign. So the detection rate of Lehmann sign for spina bifida in first trimester was just 9%. If we're talking about banana, so banana sign, banana shape, the brain, the cerebellum, normal cerebellum has banana shape, and it's not so easy visible, especially if it's banana in first trimester of pregnancy. It is easy visible at 15 weeks, but not at 13 weeks. So if you are scanning spine itself, there are two problems. First is low densification. Second, look at this 3D, because it's this 3D that I did for lady that she has spina bifida previously. And this is normal baby that there is image like there is spina bifida. Why the image is like spina bifida? Because actually the skin is very, very thin. And the bone elements of the processes, those produces the image like there is two lines and there is nothing in between. So this is normal baby, but actually if you are doing this 3D, it's frightening 3D because it looks like it's spina bifida. So there are publications and quite many publications and all those authors are not happy with me, but they're telling that if you will measure brainstem and if you will measure distance between brainstem and occipital bone, you can detect spina bifida by measurements. And I think this phenomenon is correct, that there is the brainstem is thicker if the baby has spina bifida, but I don't understand why you need to do those measurements. And actually, I know that if you're doing measurement, you have high chance to miss spina bifida, because I have quite many images of measurements of spina bifida by people who miss spina bifida doing measurement, because they did normal measurement, and spina bifida baby was found at 20 weeks. And second question, why we are not measuring banana? Because if you measure banana, you will get the number confirming your diagnosis. Banana will be, cerebellum for spina bifida will be smaller than normal cerebellum. So you can publish paper that actually the small cerebellum associated with spina bifida, why not? But fortunately, we're not doing this because we're just looking for shape, we're just looking for size, and we can understand that baby has spina bifida without any measurements. Just after looking, go to spine and find this spina bifida. So, and additional thing, how to measure fourth ventricle? Because this is normal baby, has a fourth ventricle, a 12 weeks baby. And actually you can see that shape of fourth ventricle is extremely complicated. People, I believe that they are thinking to measure this distance, but why not measure this distance? Why not to measure transverse distance? So there are many ways how to check, measure this fourth ventricle. And additional thing that I found that the shape of, if you will do volumes for all those normal babies fourth ventricle, you can find absolutely different shapes of fourth ventricle, and all those shapes are normal. So why to do measurements? So again, this is why to do this instead of looking for something else. So there's publications how to measure, how to, so we will how we started to do works with spina bifida. We were looking for the brains, not for spina bifida. We were interested in fourth ventricle for Dandy Walker group of malformations. And my colleague that was doctor that actually she was leading this study about brains, she with knowledge about intracranial translucency and there is that is disappears for spina bifida babies, she scanned this baby. She did transabdominal and transvaginal scan. On transabdominal scan, she decided that everything looks okay. She did scan of spine. She was decided that everything is okay. And baby came back at 22 weeks. And at 22 weeks, the baby has lemon sign, banana that we can see here, and baby has a big open spina bifida in this part that she scanned. So it was very upsetting because she tried to exclude spina bifida, but it was missed. Fortunately, what happened, that we got the volume that she taken of the brain. What I was showing you how to take volume, so she taking the volume of the brain. And after looking for the volume of the brain, actually we understood that baby with spina bifida has leakage of the fluid from the brain, and it's visible, easy visible, especially it will compare with normal brain. So, and we call this dried up brain. So the brain without fluid. And if you're looking retrospectively for her picture from transvaginal scan that she was thinking it's normal, if you will show me this picture, I will tell you that I'm extremely suspicious that the baby has spina bifida, like that the case that Michael Gruber, that they just I've seen first picture. I can tell you that this is the brain that was decompression of the brain, and that's why the brain looks collapsed. And in the case of Michael Gruber, it was because of encephalocele, not spina bifida, but it was the same type of decompression. There is good paper actually published from group of Finn from Australia, that they found that if we measure distance between aqueduct and occipital bone, you can the distance of this distance is shorter for babies with spina bifida, but it's again measurements. And the problem of measurement of aqueduct for spina bifida babies is that it's very difficult sometimes to see aqueduct itself because of collapse of the brain. So I don't think that the measurement that they proposed will work. But I think the idea that they have is correct, because when I was thinking how to we, instead of doing 3D scans of the brain complicated, what can we found as a marker for spina bifida, and I had 10 volumes of spina bifida brains that we collected, I found that if there is displacement of the mesencephalon and its deformation against occipital bone, those babies will have spina bifida. And it's easy visible, not just by doing transvaginal scan, it's easy visible from doing transabdominal scan. So we published this paper with Nikolaidis about dried up brain, but we haven't used this terminology in the paper, and this is the comparison between normal brain and brain with spina bifida. And I just go fast because I would like to tell you about CRASH more. So, and after I have those images that we published, and I have also collected images from all the publications, and I found that yes, if there is spina bifida, there is some catastrophic event here, that mesencephalon with aqueduct just crushed again occipital bone. And this is another paper from a French group from 2002, that they were talking about parallelism of the, but it's parallelism is not correct, because it depends just on the angle of scanning, because you can get for normal brain also parallel image of mesencephalon and thalamus. So, and I think the correct name of this phenomenon is CRASH, because it's like car just crashing inside of the wall, and the wall is occipital bone. So this is crushed brain with spina bifida, and this is normal mesencephalon. So I asked my son, and he did this movie, and there are two babies that are twins, And one baby has normal brain and normal spine, and this is normal brain and normal spine, aqueduct, mesencephalon, occipital bone, and now this is phenomenon of crush, so bam! And this is deformation, and this is the brain of second baby that has spina bifida. So normal baby, caught twin with spina bifida. So it's easy visible, and also dried eye up brain. So if you have those features, it is decompression of the brain, and the only reason that it will be decompression of the brain if the baby is alive is open or spina bifida or encephalocele or other defect that creates drop in pressure. Of course, you need to confirm spina bifida by scanning the spine itself. And this 11-week transabdominal scan with 9L probe that you can see a meningomyelocele cell. This is sagittal view, this is transverse plane, and this is coronal. No, sorry, this is coronal, this is transverse. And it looks quite similar for different babies. So this is two different cases that you can see that it looks quite similar. So some babies with spina bifida, they will have also kyphosis. And you can see this deformation of the spine. This is demo case, how you need to train your staff. So this is a lady that was scanned by one of our doctors that are doing screening scans. And the baby has spina bifida, but not here. Baby has spina bifida in the lumbar area down. And as you can see, it's more visible here because baby is sitting in the position that this part of the spine is close to the uterine wall, and it's very difficult to scan this part of the spine. So lady was young, she had no any risk factors for neural tube defects. She was taking folic acid, she was scanned by a research fellow using Voluson 730 transabdominal. She was scanned at nearly 12 weeks, and nuchal was normal, risk was low, but lady detected that baby has crush. And she asked me to scan, I scan, this is my scan, transabdominal scan, which, as you understand, the resolution is not good, but I can see that mesencephalon is displaced and it's very suspicious. So I did this transvaginal scan. So this is from the moment how you introduce transvaginal transducer. So it's just velocity that you can make diagnosis. Your transducer, and you can see that brain is crushed. That's it. So it takes less than half a minute to make diagnosis of spina bifida. This is the same baby with enlargement. You can see dried up brain. Of course, I'm doing volumes for all those babies, and on volume, you can see also very well how it's crushed and dried up. And it taken us nearly 2 weeks, 10 days, to confirm the presence of the lesion in the spine, because it was poorly visible, spinal lesion. And because we were not able to confirm this lesion, us is taking additional about 10 days. So half a year later, the mother came back at 11 weeks of her next pregnancy. I measured nuchal translucence, was looking at the brainstem and have no any suspicion that something abnormal. But I did internal scan, and when I introduced the transducer, I was shocked because second baby was crushed. So this second baby has also crushed sign. So, and those are two babies. This is December 2014, and this is March 2015. And in both cases, you can see how fast the diagnosis is made from the moment that you just started to do the scan. So this is first baby, this is second baby, and they both has the same images. So if we will look for cross sections, so the brain is dried up, it means that choreoplexuses are filling practically all the spaces of the ventricles. It's kind of maybe normal variation for the first trimester, not first trimester, for 11 weeks. But in this case, as you can see, this is bone, and this is choreoplexus, and this is tissue of hemisphere. So practically there is no any brain tissue, because it's really collapsed in between choreoplexuses and the bones of the skull. And if you will go, there is no projection of third ventricle here. There is no midline cystic structure because it's collapsed. And if you go down, so you will see that there is crush, here there is crush, and actually later there is transition from crush to banana sign. So this is fantastic, because I was in Kazakhstan in Almaty half a year before the course. Half a year ago, I was in Kazakhstan in Almaty, and people working there, they have difficulties because they have really it's difficult environment that they're working. It's not easy to work there. But after my course, they sent me three cases of diagnosis of spina bifida at 12 weeks. So this is first crush, and just a second, you'll see spina bifida itself. So it's Dr. Victoria Guy. It's, some of the cases, it's not her case, it's cases of the doctors that work in her center. This second case, crush and spina bifida, and I have third case. So I think it's good to train, to learn, and if you really trained, you can do those diagnoses, and you can do those beautiful images and clips. And this is not me, because this is Samsung. I'm not scanned with Samsung, so I'm not making this history. So it's really diagnosed by doctors that just trained and started to check for this. So this is another Dave Demmer case, that one of our best research fellows. She scanned and make those pictures of all the measurements that they're thinking that helps. And she was happy with those measurements. And she was, and this is my image, that when I scanned, I was a little bit strange for me was everything here, but I decided that this is for ventricle, that it's not normal. Now I know that this part is cerebellum. This part is cerebellum, that it's compressed between mesencephalon and brainstem. But at that moment that I scanned, I was thinking that it's for ventricle. And the reason why she referred this lady is was that the stomach was on the right side of the, so she was referred because of right sided stomach. So this is stomach, and this is left sided heart. And I was thinking about atrioisomerism, so I spent time for checking IVC and to checking different, to exclude isomerism for this baby. And actually the heart and all connections were normal. I did fit with a cardiography, and it was okay, transvaginal. But when I introduced transvaginal transducer, I was absolutely shocked, because what I did, I just rotated to have a look on the brain, and when I rotate, I've seen that the brain is crushed. So the brain is crushed, and it means that it was spina bifida that I was scanning this lady for nearly 20 minutes. We're not able to think about spina bifida. And so we have no time just to see all the clip. And this is spina bifida that baby has. And this is 3D reconstruction of this same spina bifida. So it comes from here, from the lower thoracic and coming down. So it's huge spina bifida, which was nearly missed without scar. So other cases that this is another case that somebody measured, and this is spina bifida that was diagnosed at 20 weeks. And especially that what upsets me that people who will measure it and they told it is normal were not even able to detect this deformation of the spine, which was probably visible if you are really looking for the spine. So what I think there is the pathophysiological mechanism of open spina bifida is that leakage of drop of pressure, leakage of the fluid, and not first leakage and second drop of pressure, and there is dried up brain and collapse of the skull, which produce small size of the head even at this stage of pregnancy, and later it produces Lehmann sign, and secondary events are collapse of the third ventricle, obliteration of the fourth ventricle, abnormal looking lateral ventricle, small aqueduct, and crush sign. So, and there's condition called OEIS complex, which is omphalocele extrophy, usually cloacal extrophy, and imperforate anus and spinal defects. So it's interesting, but for this specific condition, in the series that I have, majority of the babies, they have no crush sign. They have spinal lesions, and this baby has spinal lesion from thorax down. Actually, you can't see spine at all. But because probably those lesions are closed, there is no pressure in the drop pressure in the brain, and this baby had a very, very normal brain. And this is actually this big cystic structure in the abdomen. This is cloacal membrane. And this is cloaca, and this membrane will rupture in the future, and it will be open cloaca, but at this stage is still membrane. So this case of spina bifida occulta, that was, you see, this is spina bifida skin covered. There is no classical crush sign, but there is some displacement of mesencephalon. This lady got counseling actually that prognosis of this spina bifida is favorable, and it's difficult to predict outcome, but this is probably the best of all spina bifidas. But after very good counseling, quite reassuring, she decided to terminate the pregnancy. So this is the case. And so we have no time to talk about this. And this is important because this is transition between crush and banana. So at the end of 13 weeks and beginning 14 weeks, crush maybe not be evident because growing cerebellum actually pushes the mesencephalon back. And but if it's pushed mesencephalon back, you can see in this case banana. So this is transition at the end of 13, beginning 14 weeks. You starting to see banana sign, but growing cerebellum pushes mesencephalon back. So crush sign is the best time for use. Crush sign is about 12 weeks of pregnancy. So, and this is case that I did neuro course just 1 month ago, and my colleague sent me from Italy, one of the also ladies that were trained. So she sent me pictures that I, and she with question mark, and I wrote that, look, it's supposed to be spina bifida because of your pictures, and she told, yes, it is spina bifida. So some people trying to check if I am if I can do diagnosis. So I can do diagnosis of spina bifida by pictures of others. And I asked her, can you describe how you detect the spina bifida? So she wrote here. So, and she's very, very nice Italian doctor. So she wrote that I saw this lady at 12 weeks pregnancy for combined screening, which was low risk and normal nuchal. And at this time, I first noticed that choroid plexus were feeling the skull much more than usual. So she's seen this, she's seen dried up brain. So I also realized that in axial plane, fourth ventricle was reduced. And then I took the measurement of the brain stem. So she was trained to do those measurements, and the measurements were actually abnormal. And I booked follow-up scan, so she decided to rescan this lady, and she told that she needs to check again. She doesn't told that she thinks that baby has spina bifida. And actually, when she came back at 16 weeks, so she was able to demonstrate this spina bifida. But the issue that she did all the measurements, yes, and measurements were abnormal, but when she did the measurements, she already knew that she thinks that the baby has spina bifida. So instead of spending time to doing measurements, actually you just need to scan the brain and to understand that it's very high risk for the spina bifida. So proposed pathway of screening for open spina bifida is to look for crush sign, to look for abnormal choroid plexuses. If somebody wants to measure something in the brain or to look for intracranial translucency, you are very welcome. If you can detect by using this technique spina bifida, it's very good. And for diagnosis, you need to do a neurosonography to see that it's really dried up brain. And of course, you need to find spinal defect because counseling will depend on the level of this defect of the spine. So, conclusions, open spina bifida is potentially 100 detectable at first trimester, not first trimester, 11, 13 plus 6 days, and we need to have appropriate training, and this will improve diagnostic accuracy. And this is another amazing case because quite many years ago I went to one of the big Russian cities. I was invited to do neuro course, and it was groups of doctors of the experts, and they brought four ladies for scanning in first semester to train how to check spina bifida, and three ladies were absolutely fine, and lady number four, when they started to scan, I've seen crush sign. Just she was scanned, I was amazed again. So how is possible that they are calling four random ladies for discussion of you know, first trimester neurosonography, and one of those ladies by chance has spina bifida? That happens 1 in 3,000 cases. Amazing. But the baby has crush sign, and again, so I told that I think you need to wait a little bit and to scan again at around 15 weeks to confirm the diagnosis, and they scanned late at 15 weeks, and it was spina bifida, and so they terminate the pregnancy. So thank you very much.